Hello guys, welcome to J Academy. In this video, I am going to tell you about how to implement KNN algorithm. And here we are going to use IDIS dataset. So there are following steps will be used to implement the KNN algorithm. The first one is importing the libraries which are required. And then the second one is reading or loading the dataset. The third step is data visualization and data normalization. And the fourth one is splitting the dataset into training and testing. And the fifth is training the model and predicting the from the model. So here we are going to implement the libraries, importing the libraries. So we have to use the command import pandas as pd. So here as is going to work as alias, so that instead of pandas you can use pd and work out. Then you have to import numpy as np. Then for plotting you have got matplotlib.pyplot as plt. Then from the scikit-learn packages, which is a package containing the algorithm, the machine learning, so here we are going to import the nearest neighbor classifier from sklearn.neighbors API. then from sklearn we have to import pre-processing so that we can do some pre-processing of the data. Then from sklearn.model_selection we can import train test split, so that we can split the data into training part and the other part of the data will be for the testing. So you already know that KNN is a classification algorithm, and in any classification algorithm you have to train the model with some part of the data, and the remaining part you can test and find out the accuracy. So that is the first part is done. We will now read the data set. So iris equal to pd.read_csv, and in the bracket you write iris.csv. So here if you want to read the csv file, you have to give read_csv, okay, and then the name of the file. Now if you want to find out iris.head, we will give this command, so that when you give this head, it is going to print by default 5 rows of the data set. So here from these 5 rows we can understand that the data set has got, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 attributes. And here these 1, 2, 3, 4, that is sepal length, sepal width, petal length and petal width are your attributes, or you can say variables, whereas species is your target or predictor or class label. Okay. So when you give head, we can see these 5 rows, so top 5 rows of your data set. Now suppose you want to see only 3, you can type 3 inside this head and run, you will get the first 3 rows of your data set. Similarly, if you want to find out the bottom 5, you have to write iris.tail and run this. So you are going to get the bottom 5 rows of your data set. Next, we would like to see know more about the data set, because unless you have an idea about your data set, it is very hard to do any sort of analysis. So let us find out how many rows and columns are there in the data set. So if you write iris.shape, we will find out this is the output is, we'll run it, 150, 5, that means there are 150 rows and 5 columns. So already 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 columns are there, and there will be a total of 0 to 149, that is 150 rows are there. Now we want to know furthermore about the what are the species you are going to have for this iris data set. So, and what is the value count, like how many values in your out of 150, how many species belong to certain categories. So when you, so we have to give iris, then the name of the column dot values underscore count, counts and run it. So we find this Virginia is 50, Setosa is 50 and versicolor is 50. So that means what? That species is having only 3 classes. So this 150 data is having, you know, equal distribution, that is 50, 50, 50. Next, if you want to find the column name of your data set, You can give iris dot columns, that this iris is working as your data frame, because already you know we have used pandas. So here we have used pandas and we have kept that your data frame inside iris. So iris dot columns is going to give you the name of all the columns of your data set. So here the names are sepal length, sepal width, petal length, petal width, and the species. Okay, next we would like to find the values. If you want to find the value of your data set, you have to give iris dot values, so you will get all the values. Like for example, iris dot column is going to give you the column name, and the values will give all the values in your data set. Next, you want to have information about your data set, you can give the command as iris.info, okay? And when you give this, you are going to get all the information about your data set. For example, here you have 150 entries are there, okay, 0 to 149 is the index number. You have a data column, there are 5 columns, and the name of the columns are there, sepal length 150, and what is the type, float. Values are stored, and species is also 150, which is of the type object. Object means all your string values will be stored in the form of the type object. Okay. Now, when you give this command, next is that iris.describe. It is going to give you the for all the attributes which has got numerical values, it will give a statistic of that. For example, what is the count, total count of sepal length, sepal width, petal length, petal width. But you can see that species, since it has a name, it has a categorical values like in the form of name, so that is missing. Okay, so here what is the count of it, what is the mean of that sepal length, sepal width, then the standard deviation, then what is the minimum value in that data set, what is the maximum, then what is the 25 percentile, 50 percentile, and 75 percentile of that value. The entire statistic is given in this iris.describe. Okay, so if you want to find the value of all the columns, so you have to give inside include all. So when you give include all, you can get the species also, and there is a value called unique. So unique is going to give, you know, three values of species are unique. The top value is Virginia and the frequency is 50. So you are going to get, and since these like mean, standard deviation cannot be calculated on the value of categorical data because that is a name, so you will not get those information. So you will get not a number. So in classification, what we need to do is that we have to take around 70% for training and 30% for testing the data set. So all these which are independent variables, or you can say attributes, from sepal length till petal width, okay, so we will consider this as x, and this will be your y, this species will be your y, okay. So we will do what, we will split the data set into x train, okay, that means till here this will be x train and this is y train. We will make the model. So here the first four columns 1, 2, 3, 4 will be kept as x, and the column species will be kept as y. Okay, let's see how it is being done. So here we will use x equal to iris dot I location means index location. So the first one is a row, so this one is row before comma, after comma is indicating your column. So colon means we require all the rows, okay, from the starting till the end, and column we require from 0 to 2, 4 means your 0, 1, 2, 3. So the first 4 column will be a part. So all the rows and the first 4 column will be a part of x. So let's see what is the value of x. X dot head is going to have these values, except the last column, that is your species column. Now that species column we are going to keep it in y. So how we are going to do it? Y equal to iris dot I location. So before comma I told you it's all rows. So when you give colon means all rows are selected. Minus 1 will be, so minus 1 will be your starting from the last column. Okay, so the last column, that is your species, is going to be a part of y. So y dot head, so the first 5 values of your y is going to be presented. Next step is data normalization. So here what you have to do, you have to normalize your data, because your data might be, because they are sepal length, sepal width, might be in different units. So you have to make it in a standard form. So what we use, preprocessing dot standard scalar. So this is what we are using, the function standard scalar dot fit transform x. So this is going to do what? This will preprocess your value of x such that your mean is equal to 0 and the standard deviation equal to 1. Okay, let's see the value. So your value, you have seen that value has changed. So you have normalized your data. Now after normalization, what you can do, you can split your data into test train split. So here the test train test split, you can import from the sklearn.model_selection, and this is the format. You have to write x train comma x test comma y train comma y test equal to train test split, and in this function you are writing x comma y, that is your value, that your data in x and y set is sent, and then the test size is 0.3. What is the meaning of test size? That means out of the 100, suppose 100 data set, 100 records, 70 you are going to go for training, and the remaining 30 you are going to send it for the testing. So test size is 0.3, means 30% of your entire data frame will be kept for testing. Random state equal to 1 means if you run this program again and again, the same selection will be used. Y test shape. So here you want to check out how many Y test is there. So you have to use dot shape. So that means 45 rows are kept for testing. So you can check out what is 70, what is 30% of your, because the total data is 150. So 30% of 150 is 45 rows. So 45 rows are randomly selected and kept for testing. Now we are going to make a model. Okay. And once the model is done, we are going to predict what? We are going to predict X test. So the model, KNN model equal to K neighbor classifier, and in the bracket you have to give N underscore neighbors equal to 3. So this 3 is the value of K. Okay. That in KNN, how much you want to take. Okay, so we have taken it 3. Later on, we'll see why we are taking it 3. So KNN model dot fit X train comma Y train. So you are going to fit the model in this with this data, that is X train, that is 70% of the data you are taking to train the model. After the training is done, you will use that model to predict the value of X test. So y predict 1 equal to KNN model dot predict x underscore test. So when you use x underscore test, it will use the model and predict the class label for this x underscore test. Okay. And next, after doing that, you want to find the accuracy of the model. Okay. So in what manner are we going to find the accuracy of the model? So here we have to import accuracy underscore score from sklearn.matrix, and accuracy equal to accuracy score comma y test. So y test is the class label of x test. Okay, and y underscore predict 1. So these are the value that you are predicting for x test. Now you're going to match up how much is the accuracy between the y test value and the y predict 1. So we can check out the accuracy is already 97%. So once you get the accuracy, we can make out, okay, approximately 3% of my data is wrongly classified. Okay, so you can make a confusion matrix. So to make the confusion matrix, you have to again import confusion matrix from sklearn.matrix, and you have to use cm equal to confusion matrix, and you need to find the confusion matrix between your actual class label as well as the predicted class label, and then you try to print that cm. So what we can see that this is truly classified, the first one, the second one, but then the third one, but out of the third one, one is misclassified, okay, wrongly classified. Okay, now we want to print this in the form of a data frame. So in the data frame, you have both your predicted as well as your y-test values. So how can you get it? CM1 equal to pd.dataframe, because why we want to convert that into a data frame, because all the values that you got in the scikit-learn, when you apply scikit-learn, it is in the form of an array. So if you want to get the output in the form of a data frame, you have to use pd.dataframe, then your data, because data is here, confusion matrix, and then here you write the index for this, and this is your column name. And here, from here, we can understand how many, when you print this, we can easily understand how many are wrongly classified. So here 14 out of 14. So here this is my actual and this is my predicted. So I can say that Virginia, so the prediction 1 is wrong, okay, and 12 data set is rightly classified out of the test data set. So out of X test, you can easily find out how many are wrongly classified. So you can now have the prediction output as well. You can check out when you print this. So here again, you know, you make the data frame y test dot values and then y predict, and then you can give the index, okay. And so if you print this, it will be in the form of rows. You have to do a transpose of it. So what I mean to say is that suppose if you print this, it will be in this form. So you, it's very, you know, you cannot read this. So what you can do is that you can put a transpose of this. So it is very easy to read. You can understand, okay, y test value is setosa, the first one, and the predict is also setosa. So you can easily find out where you can make mistake or whether they are the same classes that is being classified. Okay. Next, if you want to find out like what is the total count, you can also find the total count here. Prediction output dot iloc 0 comma. So you got the entire prediction in your data frame. Okay. Now from here you can check out how many are versicolor, setosa and Virginia. So what you have to use is that iloc 0th row, because initially, because it is not in this form. So this is a transpose form. So if you remember this, you have to take all the rows and 0th rows for the first one and all the columns. And then what is the values count, you can print. So you'll get all the values that is there in the prediction. So that's all, guys. In the next video, I'll show you how to find the value of K in the KNN algorithm.